is, I'm Kiana.
And I'm RJ. We're back at it again with this week's episode of The Weekly Show, YouTube edition.
The theater department is holding auditions for their first show. Please email Ms. Jackson for more details.
If you like to talk and are looking for competition, you can join the speech and debate team who's having their first tournament soon. Contact Ms. Jackson for more details.
What time is it?
I don't know, probably noon or something.
It's time for Groovy Smoothies with Ashton, Upstreaming with Nick, and Sebastian's Huda.
What's up, Vipers? Welcome to another episode of Groovy Smoothies with Ashton. Today, I'll be making strawberry mango smoothies. First, you're going to do 3 cups of fruit. Then, you're going to take 1/2 cup of Greek yogurt. Then, 1/3 cup of milk. Two tablespoons of juice. Also 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Then lastly, 2 cups of ice. There you have it, Vipers. That's how you make a strawberry mango smoothie. See you next time.
First one is Black Panther. It's on Disney Plus. Rest in peace to the homie. Next one is only for big strong men like myself. So if you're not a stud, I wouldn't watch it. It's The Boys. It's on Amazon. And the last one is a movie called Peanut Butter Falcon. It's really good. It's on Hulu.
Hello, and welcome back to Who Dat, where I will ask a staff member some questions, and you will try to guess who it is.
What is your favorite beverage?
That's such a hard one. Coffee?
All right. What is your favorite animal?
Puppies. Definitely puppies.
All right. And last question, what is your favorite holiday?
I feel like something in between Halloween and Christmas.
Can you guys try to guess who this is? And it is Mr. Marco.
Hi.
My name is Sebastian, and that was Who Dat.
Kiana.
Yes?
Do you watch engineering videos on YouTube?
No.
Oh, well, this one isn't for you then. If you are interested in all aspects of the engineering process, including manufacturing and project funding, join the MVEC Club by contacting Mr. Klakuluk.
They meet Tuesdays and Thursdays from 12:35 to 1:10 and Wednesdays from 12 to 1 p.m.
Speaking of clubs, if you're interested, don't forget to join the Mock Trial Club by contacting Mr. Eisen. You'll get to work with real attorneys on a fictional case.
We'll be right back after these following messages from Sebastian, T, and Stella.
Hi there. Are you looking for a club that is fun and sporty? Well, come on down to the Verado Fencing Club, where we learn how to build up our technique in sword fighting, wearing protective gear, and most importantly, having fun. If you are interested in joining or would like some more info, contact Mr. Brown.
Hey Vipers, welcome back to our YouTube channel. As always, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button. Today, I will be talking to you guys about the curbside book pickup that our school offers.
Even though we can't go to the Verado Library, we can still get our favorite books. Our Verado librarian, Mrs. Warren, came up with a clever idea to do just that. All it takes is 3 simple steps.
Step 1. Log into Destiny Discover like you would log into your Chromebook. Once you're in, find a book that you want and place it on hold.
Step 2.
Wait for your confirmation email that will tell you when your book will be ready to be picked up. Step 3, show up at your designated time and pick up your books from Ms. Warren. Don't forget to wear your mask.
And that's all there is to it, Vipers. Getting your library books is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Until next time, thanks for watching.
Hello, my name is Sebastian Huerta. Here's your weekly weather forecast. Monday, we will have a high of 103 and a low of 80. Tuesday, we will have a high of 102 and a low of 77. Wednesday, we will have a high of 102 and a low of 79. Thursday, we have a high of 100 and a low of 77. Friday, we have a high of 104 and a low of 76. Saturday, we have a high of 99 and a low of 76. And finally, Sunday, we will have a high of 103 and a low of 77. I'm your Sebastian. That was your weekly weather report.
This past Friday was the 19th anniversary of 9/11.
September 11th, 2001 was the day in which a series of civilians targeted attacks terrorized the United States, changing our world forever.
So many people's lives were lost and affected by this tragedy, so we'd like you to pause this video and take a moment of silence.
Next, you all get to see Brian and Guess What, Tease Treats, Cyberbullying PSA from Stella, and lastly, RJ's school board resolutions.
What's up, everybody? I hope you're having an amazing day today, and welcome to another episode of Guess What? In today's episode, we will be playing a game of True or False, and the questions will be about pop culture. And our contestants are Mr. Martin and Ms. Sloan.
Okay, first question. True or false? The Slinky toy was invented more than 50 years ago.
True.
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 As a misplaced radio antenna.
Well, I don't know all those technicalities.
All right, you guys are correct. The answer is true. Okay, next question. True or false, the Beatles were the first pop musicians to be awarded the MBE.
I'm going to go with false.
I don't even know what that is, so I'm going to say false.
You guys are both incorrect. It's true. All right, now the last question. True or false, the inventor of Batman also created Superman.
I'm gonna go false.
They were both in Detective Comics. So let's say true.
True? All right, the answer is false. The creator of Batman is Bob Kane and the creator of Superman is Jerry Siegel. Thanks, I really appreciate it.
All right, thank
you.
All right, you're
welcome.
Bye.
Bye.
That's it for today, guys. Thanks for sticking around, and as always, peace out.
Hey Vipers, welcome back to our YouTube channel. As always, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button. Let's get on with this video. If you don't know me, my name is T, and this is T's Treats. For the filling, you're gonna need 4 to 6 cups of peaches and 2 cups of sugar. Not 2 cups, 1.5 cups of sugar, I'm sorry. No, not 1.5 cups of sugar, 1/2 cup of sugar. For the batter, you're gonna need 2 cups of flour, 1 cup of sugar, 1.5 cup of milk, and 4 teaspoons of baking powder.
I forgot to mention you have to add 6 tablespoons melted butter into the bottom of your pan.
before you pop it into your 350 degree oven for about half an hour. Wait for it to cool and you're good to go. Stay sweet, Vipers.
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to my vlog. JK, guys, welcome back to the fourth episode of the weekly show. Okay, so today it's currently 7:40. I need to get ready for my school day. So I'm gonna do my hair, I'm gonna do my makeup, and I'm gonna change. And I will update you guys right before class. Okay, guys, I'm done with my makeup and I'm done with my hair, y'all. Okay, and then now I'm gonna show you guys my OOTD. So my OOTD is just this plain blue tank top. It's literally like so boring, and some sweats, and that's literally it. But I need to go because I'm gonna be late for my first hour and I have a test. Okay, guys, so we just got let out of class. I finished my test. I have to watch this video for it, but then that'd be all for forensics. And then now I'm gonna go to my second class and I'll update you after. Okay, guys, so I'm out of my second hour and class isn't over, but like I'm finished with everything I have to do. So I'm gonna paint my nails and watch Grey's Anatomy, and then I'll update you guys when I go to eat. Hey guys, update, it is time for lunch. So I'm gonna go get some food. I painted my nails, I changed. So I'm gonna show you guys the OOTD. It's just this black shirt, right? And some gray leggings, and I'm wearing black sandals. That's it, but I'm gonna go get myself some food and then I'll update you guys later. Okay guys, I just came back and I got my food. I'm gonna do some work real quick because it is Viper Success, and yeah. Hey guys, it's 1:15, my last and final class of the day. I'll see you after school. Hey guys, it's officially 3:05. It's officially the end of the day. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Make sure to give a like and subscribe.
Hello, Verado Vipers. I'm Robert Jones reporting live from KVHS. On August 20th, 2020, the OFRE Union High School District came up with three resolutions regarding Black Lives Matter, racial equity, and success rates involving students of color. Today, I'm meeting with school governing board member Mrs. Mariana Sandoval to discuss what this means for Verado High School.
First of all, good morning and thank you for inviting me to discuss this very important issue.
Of course. My first question is, what do these three resolutions address, and why did the governing board decide to come up with them now?
So the three resolutions were brought forward. I had been requesting that they be placed on the agenda since the death of George Floyd. There was some discussion with other board members as to which one addressed the problem more holistically. And basically what the resolution calls for is action to end systematic racism and violence against Black, Brown, and Native American students.
How might staff members and administration see changes in policies this year?
Well, the resolution calls for the dismantling of practices that are limiting funding opportunities for Black, Brown, and Indigenous students. It calls for training on implicit bias, trauma-informed practices, and also it calls for us to work with our local community leaders in Avondale, Buckeye, Goodyear, to see how we can improve the relationship between students and SROs. It just calls for all of us to work together to learn on how to best and better address these racist acts.
I've noticed the resolution state that data involving success rates of Black and Brown students emphasize a deficit. How can these students be able to measure a difference in their academic success rates?
For one, I would hope that they see a reduction in suspension rates. We had really high suspension rates in especially Black and Brown students. I would hope they could also see improvement in their test scores, their grades, and their treatment overall. The environment is where they attend school.
Lastly, I'd like to know how students of color might see equity being enforced in a school setting. What are you doing to make sure that students feel like they matter?
Well, again, not suspending them at higher rates, right? Improving the relationships with the SROs that are on campus and making sure that discipline is addressed, not in a punitive manner, but implementing more restorative justice practices instead of, you know, suspending and punishing, which doesn't help the student's success. It makes it harder to achieve. And so I think that students should be able to feel the difference in treatment, in how they're not singled out just because of the color of their skin, or assumed that they can't learn or they're not capable.
Well, that's all of our questions that I have for you today. Thank you for joining us to elaborate on what these resolutions are about.
You're very welcome. Thank you for having me.
This concludes our interview. Thank you for joining us today to get a better understanding of these new resolutions. See you later, Vipers.
Hi, I'm Nick, and it's KVHS Sports. Swim and dive and badminton's first competition are both today. And that's it. This has been Nick. See you later, Vipers.
We've reached the end of our show for today. As always, I'm Kiana.
And I'm RJ. Peace out, Vipers.
Hey, Vipers.
Thanks for watching
this episode of
The Weekly Show.
And don't forget to subscribe
to our channel
for future updates.
Make sure to like
and subscribe.